major cause of our problem. Because the governors are the engine room to decide what the economy becomes. Because they have the masses, the people, and they have the land. Agreed. They are talking about constitutional changes to the land use decree and this to do change. But nobody stops you from farming. If your government decides to go and clear some land massively and allocate it to your citizens to farm and get them farm inputs, nobody is going to stop you. So, but every time funds are allocated, you find that nobody accounts for what funds are used for. And we can't go on this way. I want to say one thing, that the presidents of anybody who is president of Nigeria should be treated with some bit of understanding. Because the problem of Nigeria per se, the president has a say in it, but it's not totally the way Nigerians think. Because the president has no single person under his portfolio. He can give executive order apart from his ministers. The president has no land that he can go and say, I want to do agri. You know? The president is just in charge of that Aso Rock. But the governors, they have the resources to move mountains. United States of America is a federal system of government. You see, the states are there generating income and plowing back to federal. It's not, but here it's the other way around. Federal is feeding bottle in the states. So what we're practicing is feeding bottle federalism. That's what we're practicing. And that cannot be sustained. Where federal will be feeding 36 mouths plus FCT every month. We are lucky the oil price has just come up a bit, but it's very deceitful. Because you know this time is going to slop again. And by the time it goes down to about $30 per barrel, the economy will collapse. Because it costs Nigeria $27 to produce one barrel of oil. Explore, produce, export. It costs Nigeria $27 to produce one barrel of oil. So if the oil price now goes below $27, there's no market. We're in crisis. In Saudi Arabia and most other countries, they spend just about $9 to produce a barrel of oil. So the profit margin is, you know, appreciable. But in Nigeria, the profit margin is so marginal. And we still keep on hampering at making our economy to be monocultural, dependent on oil. It's very deceitful.
Do you think Nigeria is having a spiritual problem, sir? Because you've been saying all this for years, and it appears that nobody is changing anything.
Well, I have been writing my books. I've been alarming everybody. I've been tuning like cool to make people sit up, to change direction. But it seems everybody is turning a deaf ear. But I'm saying this out of patriotism, because Nigeria is the only country we have, like Buhari did say. And we have nowhere else to go than to stay in Nigeria and do something about salvaging it. But the willpower to do the bitter things that we ought to do, they look bitter, but they are the solutions. When we're talking about restructuring, people tend to gloat over it and commonize it and just laugh over it. It's a major problem. And even in the country today, when the president came on board, he reduced the number of ministries from 45 to 25. Is that not restructuring? So what is so, all the hue and cry of restructuring, they are debating it as if it's something from the moon. It is something you do to take care of tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be worse than it is today. And the problem we have in Africa, in Nigeria in particular, is that we don't plan ahead. Nobody looks 10, 20 years ahead. The days of General Gowon, when he was head of state and the First Republic, we used to have this 5-year development plan, whereby there is a plan of what we'll do in the next 5 years. Now, we don't have. There's no development plan. It's every year. we'll change the plan. And that's why I find that inconsistency is the major problem in Nigerian government.
Well, Vision 2020 and Vision 2015.
Yeah, also a vision.
Now we're in 2017, sir.
We are not consistent. Everybody comes on with his own plan. And when another government comes tomorrow, he'll have his own plan. Discard the plan of the previous government. And we're just going around in circles. So I think time has come to really, because time is running out. The resources are getting thinner and thinner. And the masses are getting very, very restive. Very restive, because the quantum of unemployment we have, it just requires a little spark, and it will be conflagratory. It will be unbelievable when the inferno starts. So we must start now to diffuse the explosive device that unemployment is creating. We must start to diffuse it. Even what is happening about this slavery thing is serious. There are sons and daughters who are trying to cross the Mediterranean Sea to Europe.
Libya, South Africa.
And getting enslaved in the process.
Yeah,
and when somebody graduates and stays 7 years, no work. A young man is there, no means of livelihood, with family, with wife and children, no hotels. So we must start to do something. We must not, when people are talking about minimum pay, I say, what minimum pay? There should be also maximum pay.
What do you mean by maximum pay?
Somebody should not earn more than a particular, like you say, okay, the minimum pay is 18,000 naira. Somebody should not earn more than 10 times what this Nigeria is earning. And if you do that, you find that there will be equity. Money could go around. The state governors who now take billions of naira, even a trillion, security vote, there will be money to pay everybody. Because if it's the constitution that at the most, let's say the highest Nigerian should earn 100 times the minimum salary of the average Nigerian. So if the minimum pays 18,000 as it is now, we're talking about 1.8 million maximum. Maximum with everything put in.
For
security with everything. So when we're talking about that minimum, there should also be max. What should be the maximum? There should be a cutoff point. Nobody should earn more than
maximum pay for the elites.
For the elites.
Yeah.
There should be something so that they don't go beyond that. So that there be equity and distribution of income. So these are measures. There are so many things that when we talk about restructuring, there are so many things that could be done to reventilate the economy and liberalize the system and diffuse the tension.